Hey everybody, it's Wendy. Welcome. So excited you're here today. I have deemed this card the cussing card. We're going to get into why that it is called that. But for now, I want to definitely share these products with you because I couldn't wait to get my hands on them. These are brand new products from the 2018 Stampin' Up! Occasions catalog. They will be available to purchase January 3rd. However, this video is going to serve as a public service announcement in that if you don't have patience, you should not purchase this set. Or if you have any sort of arthritis or physical disability that doesn't allow your hands to be very nimble, this set could also be extremely frustrating for you. It was for me, so we're going to get into this. My promise is always to be honest and forthright and never try to sell you something just to sell it to you. So this piece of cardstock here is cut at 4 inches by 5 1/4, and then it was, by 5 inches. No, let me start over. It's cut at 5 inches by 8 inches. And then I scored it at the 4-inch mark on each side of the paper. So I'm going to line up these little slits of this die with the little score marks that I made in my Stampin' Trimmer. Now, you see, I'm already flustered and we haven't even started. I'm like trying to explain it to you and I'm getting flustered. I'm making a huge mistake here and I'm gonna be very curious if anyone catches it while I'm doing it. I almost edited this whole section out and then I left it in because it's quite funny. So I went through the whole process of running this through my die cut and realized the die was upside down. Yes, that is right. I didn't cut it because I had the die. You see me pausing right here? It's because I'm mad. So I had already made 2 of these cards, so I knew how this worked. And I was so flustered that I didn't put the die the right way. It's the first time I've ever done something. I've never done that before. I've never cut into my Big Shot with the die facing the wrong way. Thank God it didn't break the die. I got a new piece of paper, ran it through again, and obviously you can see it cut beautifully. So the part of this die that is frustrating is not the cutting or anything. It is the actual making it pop up part that made me cuss like a sailor. I'm not gonna lie to you. I love Jesus, but I cuss a little. I've told you that before. So when something really gets my goat, I get mad. I do. And it's an issue and it needs to be worked on and I'm trying. And that's all I can say about that. So I'm scoring with my bone folder right along the bottom edge of the cutout. You need to do that. Please do that. Then I'm popping very gently all of these pieces out of the die framework, basically. Kind of just popping them up and away from the back. Then I need to fold on this bottom score line, but you don't want to fold the sides. So that's the part of this that's difficult. The sides there that you see me trying to hold down, you don't want to make a crease or a score line there. So you've got to hold those parts down and pull this part forward. So this has kind of been the best method for me, was to push down and pull forward at the same time. Then you need to run your bone folder all along the tracks, on the top side of the track and the bottom side of the track. I watched Brandy Barnard's video on how to do this, and she works for Stampin' Up, and she's the one that did the video, and she makes it look so easy, and she's all calm and sweet the whole time she's doing it. And I'm just gonna say, Brandy, hats off to you, because this was not an easy task. Now I've got to fold in on this track, and then I'm gonna fold back so that the track looks flat. So I'm going to continue with this process while we chat. You can just see me here working it very gently because you don't want to wrinkle up and mess up all of the little pieces on the front of the roller coaster. So here's the thing with this set. When I saw this in the catalog, I squealed. I was like, oh my God, cutest thing ever. Absolutely loved it. I still love it when it's completed. But it is work, people. It is work. You better give this card to somebody you love, because you see the work that is involved in getting this pop-up to do its thing. It's so cute. So you're just going to have to make up your mind if you feel like it's worth the investment for this pop-up center. Now, hang with me till the end so that you can see the finished card, because that's the part, right, that you're going to have to, like, go, okay, well, God, that card is really, really cute. Maybe it would be worth it. But you see how gentle I'm being and how much time this is taking. And I could have easily edited this video to make it look like this went really fast, but I refused to do so because I really wanted you to see how long it took. So then you're going to fold your cardstock, which is cut at 8.5 by 5.5, regular size cardstock, and then adhere this in the center. And the little creases that the die creates for you are the creases that you're gonna line those up with the inside of the card. Okay, so as you can see, I put it in the card, and I can tell, because I've made 3 of these at this point, that I don't have it bent enough on the track, because that track has to close and fold down flat. So you have to really get these bent. Now, the other option is, if you don't want to worry about the track folding up flat, just don't make it a folding closing card. Just leave, meaning, okay, what I'm trying to say is leave the card open and just give it to somebody like that. You could do that as well, as a decoration or something, or you could set it out as a decoration at a party or something like that. It is such a cute card when it is finished, but you see that it is a ton of work to get these folded correctly. So then, because you've manipulated this paper so much, you do get some wrinkles on the front of the tracks, the little spokes or the stands there that are holding up the roller coaster. You get some wrinkles and crinkles in those. So that's just something to be aware of, that you're probably going to need to cover them up. Now, that part of it's super easy. You just take the die, cut it again in a color or a print or whatever you want to do, trim away the track area, and cover the part that you want to cover. Now, I used, not Fast Fuse, I used Tombow Mono Multi-Glue for this, because I found that it works way better. And you really want to glue down those side pieces. Brandy's video doesn't show that, and I think that it's an important step that actually helps this whole card come together easier. So then I just kind of like pulled the card away and added glue to the back of this piece and then lay it down. It's work, people. It's work. But it was worth it in the end, I have to say. So it's just one of those things where I almost didn't even do a video. I almost didn't even show you. And then I was like, you know what? Don't be like that. I'm not going to be that guy that's like, oh gosh, this was really hard to do, and so now I'm not going to show them because I might not sell any of these. No. I love the card. I love how it came together. If you buy one, you buy one. If you don't, you don't. But at least now you know the truth. Now you know it's going to take some effort to get this sucker together. Okay? It's not going to be easy. But look how cute it is when you're done. So I'm going to show you my finished projects as well, because I didn't want to take the time to decorate this whole thing. I really just wanted to focus on showing you how to make it. And right here, what I'm doing is I'm sticking my fingers inside the tracks. I'm folding the card forward and I'm pushing on the tracks in order to get them to fold down appropriately like that, so that when the card is closed, they lay flat like they're supposed to and nothing is being destroyed. So I am now opening up the tracks, and you can see here, I just wanted to show you where those little wrinkles were I showed you there. That's just literally from manipulating this paper so much. Now, the tip I have for you, look how cute this is to maybe try using Whisper White cardstock that is a regular weight cardstock versus thick. I used Whisper White thick cardstock because that's all I have. So I definitely could see that this would be a lot easier to do if you used a regular Whisper White cardstock that was a less weight. I think it's a 65-pound weight versus the 80 or 100-pound weight that I used. So the fronts of the tracks here, you can see all I did was just cut extras out and laid it right over the top, and it's got a little shadow there and it's perfectly fine. And then I did the clouds and the sunshine, and they came together really cute. So if you want to see other videos from me with sneak peek stuff that's coming up, you can click on either one of the images that you see here. You can click on the little circle with my face in it to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Make sure that you hang out with me again later this week on Friday for my 11th week of 12 Weeks of Christmas. Bye-bye.